Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, I am Sayyid Aslam Parveez Shah, Assistant Professor of Statistics at Government College of Commerce and Economics, Dr. Ziauddin Ahmad Road, Karachi. Dear students, today is the topic of my lecture is correlation and regression. Correlation and regression is the topic of business maths and statistics. That is the subject of BCom Part 1. Coefficient of correlation and regression is very important chapter of the section B. That's why chose to select my lecture on this topic. Or this way, we will continue our lectures according to our syllabus, inshallah. Correlation means to find the relationship between two variables, the degree of relationship between two variables. It is very helpful tool to find the relationship between the two variables. Example. There are various types of examples for the correlation, but some of them are written here like sales and advertisement. We can find the relationship between the sales and advertisement. What is the relation of the sales with the advertisement? By using our techniques, we can find this way the price and demand. What is the relation between the price and demand? Also, by using the techniques, by methods of the correlation, we can find. The third example which I write here, that is the age and weight. Also, age and weight are related in each other. So, by using the methods, techniques of the correlation, we can find easily. We will learn these things in the examples in the continued classes. The types of correlation means generally we know the relation, word meaning of relation. Relation means taluk. What type of relation exists in our daily life? Everyone know about the relations statements. That are positive relation. So by using correlation, we can find the positive relation. Similarly, the negative relation, it means there also negative correlation exists. We can find the relation negative and no or zero correlation. So generally everyone know about the types of the relations, positive, negative and the zero correlation. In the correlation, at what condition the correlation may be positive? When the two variables where I discuss about the sales and advertisement. Sales is the variable one and the advertisement is another variable. There are two variables. So what is the relationship between the one variable to another variable? If these two variables are directly proportional means if one variable is increase, also another variable increases, it means this one is the example of the directly proportional. If one variable is decrease, also another variable is decrease, it is also known as the directly proportional variables. If two variables are directly proportional, it means there is the positive relation between these two variables. Negative correlation, inversely proportional variables. Inversely proportional variables means in opposite directions. If one is increase, another decreases. This one is known as the opposite direction. So the opposite direction variables are known as the negative correlation. Similarly, one is decrease, another is increase. It is also known as the opposite direction, inversely proportional. So this one is the negative correlation. If there is no such type of relation, if it means the both variables are independent, so we can say that there is no correlation in these two variables. These are the types of correlation generally as per definition. The more we can discuss about the degrees, it means the statement on the basis of the mathematical statements, what we can assign the statement of that answer. So this will remain continue. Further, the correlation can be calculated by the methods in statistics that are discussed. Number one, mathematically correlation can be calculated by the method that is provided by the Karl-Pearson's. Karl-Pearson's method, by using we can find the correlation. Also by the graphical method, that is known as the scatter diagram. By using scatter diagram, we can find the correlation statements where the positive, negative or zero correlation. As we are discussing the calculation method of the correlations, so the number one, graphically by using scatter diagram we can find the correlation. जैसे कि हमने दो variables के हवाले से बात की है, एक variable हमने अपने examples में दिया है sales और दूसरा हमने दिया है advertisement. अगर हम sales को x से represent करते हैं और advertisement को हम y से represent करते हैं, तो उनकी जो information होगी उसको हम अपने graph पर x axis और y axis पर plot करेंगे. x axis और y axis पे plot करना हमारे लिए कोई नई बात नहीं है, और you know how we can draw the graph, how we can draw the graph by using the ordered pairs, it is already you know in the previous classes. But so if there is a statement number one, this one is the x which is used for the variable x, this one is the y which is used for the another variable y. So by using these ordered pairs, if we are going to plot the points, and if the points are plotted like this and we draw the line that is the linear straight line, स्ट्रेट लाइन शोज कि देयर इज द परफेक्ट पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशन. इफ यू ड्रॉ द लाइन दैट इज द स्ट्रेट लाइन, नाउ यू कैन कमेंट, यू कैन कमेंट के द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द एक्स एंड द वाई वेरिएबल इज परफेक्ट पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशन. परफेक्ट पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मैथमेटिकल कैलकुलेशन ऑफ द कोरिलेशन इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. बट परफेक्ट पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशन मीन्स द मैथमेटिकल आंसर प्लस वन. नंबर टू, वेरिएबल वन दैट इज नोन एज द एक्स एक्सिस, वेरिएबल टू दैट इज ऑन द वाई एक्सिस, एंड यू आर गोइंग टू ड्रॉ द पॉइंट्स एंड द शेप ऑफ द पॉइंट्स इज द लिटिल बिट फ्लक्चुएटेड. इट मीन्स दिस वन इज नॉट अ स्ट्रेट लाइन, सम कर्व्स आर हियर, but the direction is in the positive slope. So we can make the statement on the behalf of this graph that there is the positive correlation. We never calculate any answer by using the formula. Just the shape of graph tells us if there is the fluctuation, it means there is the fluctuation in the positive sense slope, there is the positive correlation. Mathematical answer may be from in the points from more than 0.1 and till 0.9. Till 0.9 this can. The third statement. Plot the point on x-axis of the variable x, plot the points on y-axis, and you plot the point here and you draw the line that is the linear in the downward shapes, negative slope. Now this straight line in this shape, if you find this straight line in this shape, now we can commit okay, there is the perfect negative correlation. Just we are discussing about the shapes of graph. On behalf of these shapes, we can mark our statement about the relationship between the two variables. Perfect negative correlation, if this line is straight, and the mathematical answer of this one will be minus 1. The fourth one, you draw the points on the x-axis and y-axis and you feel that there is the slope going to the downwards, but there is a little bit of fluctuations in the line, there is no straight line. So what we commit here? We commit here because this one is not a straight line, so but it is in the downward slope line, so you can say that there is the negative correlation. Negative correlation similarly from the minus 0.1 to 0.9, any answer can occur based on the data. Number one statement for the perfect positive correlation, negative correlation, perfect negative correlation and negative correlation. The last statement where you draw the points on the graph, x and y is given here, and you draw the points of the x on x-axis by using the y-axis, but there is the no shape of the line. You never find the shape of the line of four of these. Now this one is the new shape of the graph. So this type of graph tells you, you can make the statement that there is the no correlation. No correlation. It means no correlation. If we are going to calculate the mathematical answer of the no correlation, this may be zero or very nearby the zero. These are the five different shapes of the graph. On the basis of these shapes, we can comment about the relations. Mathematical methods for the calculation of the correlation. There are more than these are the calculation available in our books. All the methods, all the formulas we can use as per available data. What type of question is given? According the information we can apply, there are more than four, nearby five formulas, or by using other methods we can find the correlation. But some of them I want to discuss today in my class, and inshallah in the continuation of these lectures I will teach you the all methods of the calculations. So number one, that is the generally known as the Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Mr. Carl Pearson's discovered this formula. Generally everywhere the correlation is denoted with the R, symbol letter R, coefficient of correlation. Someone ask you to calculate the R, it means understood. He is asking you to calculate the coefficient of correlation. So in the previously we assign the names of the variables. Number one is the X, another one is the Y. So by using that variables information, n is the total number of observation which we collect. You collect 5 observations, 7 observations, that is denotes to the n. Summation, this one is the sigma summation notation, summation of x into y, summation x, summation y upon in the square root n summation x square minus summation x ka whole square to n summation y square minus summation y ka whole square. This one is the formula number one to find the coefficient of correlation. There is another formula I write here, that is the standard deviation between x and y upon standard deviation of x and multiply by the standard deviation of the y. There are more formulas as I already asked you. We will discuss in the continuity of the classes. By using these calculation, we can find the answer of the correlation from, that is known as the limits of the correlation. Limits of the correlation का मतलब ये होता है कि correlation का answer कहाँ से कहाँ तक आ सकता है. अगर आपने मैथमेटिकल टूल इस्तेमाल किया और कोरिलेशन का आंसर जो एग्जिस्ट करेगा वो -1 आ सकता है और वो +1 भी आ सकता है, या तो इनके दरमियान आएगा. इट मीन्स दिस नंबर लाइन इज लाइक दिस, कि देयर इज द -1, there is the +1, 0. Already discuss is between these points, ke negative perfect, negative perfect positive, no correlation. Now we can understand about this line ke this answer must be lies between the minus 1 to plus 1. Also, by using this number line, I want to tell you about the degree that already use in my scatter diagram, perfect positive correlation, perfect negative correlation, perfect positive correlation, perfect negative correlation, no correlation. It means this area, if the answer lies in this area, that is the 0.09 negative, 0.09 positive. If the answer from 0 to this area, it means there is the no correlation. And then if this exceeds from 0.1 to like 0.49, so there is the good correlation, there is some correlation that exists. And this way the degree increases the strong correlation. It means from the more than this, we can say there is the strong correlation up to 0.9. And then the perfect correlation is already in the risk case of the class. Thank you very much for the listening, and please keep continue your listening with us as we can teach you the complete course during this time period. Ya inshallah, Allah Ta'ala se umeed rakhte hain ke jald az jald hum aur aap ek dusre ke aamne samne aa jaye apne classroom, hamare classroom bahal ho jaye taki usme hum aapko mazid aapke easily aapko samjhane ki koshish kare aur aap humse har baat ka directly rujoo bhi kar sake. Barhal jo surat hal hai us surat hal ko maddenazar rakhte hue jo hum apne efforts kar sakte hain wo kar rahe hain taki aapka kisi kism ka koi loss na ho. Allah taala aapka aur hamara hafiz ho aur hifazat kare aur aap sabko aur hum sabko Allah taala apni aman mein rakhe. Thank you very much.